Mommy, what you doing? Oh, and there's Teddy. Good morning. And his sister Princess. They're both the same age. I guess they'll be turning 5 soon. Well, all the kitties are fine this year because there hasn't been any reported coyote cat killings and stuff like that happening this year because it's been so warm out, there's pretty much been no snow and cold weather this winter. Of course, last year I lost my all-gray male, I'm guessing to coyotes because there was so much snow and they moved to the city to get free lunch. And I haven't been up to much this winter, no big projects. My latest project is a bathroom ceiling repair, and some of the ceiling collapsed. I don't even know if you can see that. It's probably too dark, but I'll get a flashlight. There you go. There's a redneck repair if you ever saw one. Pizza Universal flexible car heater hose or radiator hose to replace what went bad up there. You can see that it was leaking the trap on my bathtub drain for upstairs. My downstairs bathtub is just fine, but that kind of causes ceiling to collapse, run down the wall. And so that was the cheapest, simplest solution, since it's kind of hard to get at up there. It cost me $22 to fix all that. And it hangs down low enough it catches the water that it makes a perfect trap also. Sweet. And I've already cut a perfect piece of drywall to put in its place and then blend in. And now that my catnip has aged enough, I guess I'm ready to start selling it. Got at least 500 pounds or more of the purified stuff, all ground up and ready. So I had to raise the price a little bit this year over last year because PayPal takes 11.5% of my profits. Then I have to pay 13% to the Canadian government for a HST tax on it. And then shipping went up this year at the post office, and they also charge now 13% on top of the postage. So it's $10 in North America if you want some, and it's going to be $12 to go to Europe. Comes in one of these envelopes that size, and you get about 90 to 100 grams per envelope. I'm not allowed to send more than 100 grams per envelope, or else you're going to double my shipping charges. Well, you can either mail cash to me and message me and get my address, or use my PayPal, and that's fine too. Either way, I'll get the money. And Teddy can share some of his private stock, can't ya? Mm-hmm. Yeah. You're so sweet. Teddy's pretty big now. He weighs 16 pounds. And he's not fat. He's just all male cat. He is a big suck, that's for sure. Now, we do have a bit of snow left. London did get one bash of 40 centimeters. Lasted only about 2 or 3 days before it started melting. So I did have a chance to get an awesome snowmobile ride. None of my friends did because I went out for a ride on a Wednesday and it snowed on Monday and it was too snowy to go then. But it's all done for. It's all melted. Every weekend at the farm has just been slush and mud. So we haven't had any fun doing anything. So I only plowed my driveway once this year in my hometown of London. And I haven't even had to plow at the farm yet with my dozer to try out my new homemade exhaust manifold. Oh well, if it doesn't snow this winter, I won't have any driveway repairs to do like last year in the spring because a dozer does a lot of damage. No cold starts yet either. I didn't have time that day I was up there riding around on my snowmobile a week ago. Is I had to pick up a dryer and deliver it on time. So, just spent an hour. That would have been the best day, but when I do cold starts, I want them to be good and authentic. So I want lots of snow and really cold. And hopefully that happens again to keep all you pumper guys happy.
Today is January 10th, 2012, and last year at this time, there was a pile of snow on my roof, and it had already snowed 7 feet in London. Last year we got a total of 10 feet for the whole season, second most on record.
Different than where I live in London. Nothing but a sea of mud and tidbits of snow. Nothing to look forward to every weekend.
That sucks.
Rather than drinking a few beers with friends. Dozer hasn't moved. Nothing happened until the spring. Well, maybe a cold start. Fire up the old Toyota motor. Well, there's the snowmobile I had an awesome ride with. My modified, no longer 440, but 500cc Skidoo. You can see the snow is all melted off of it. Pretty boring cold start, just like a year ago. It sat for 9 months, and I gave her 3 shots of prime on the button. And she fired up in one pull, just like last time. It was great. Still haven't even fired those ones up. So you can see the seats are covered in dust. So I guess we'll do better cold start next time if we get any snow. All else is good. That's the trade-in dryer I brought back after delivering that one and after the snowmobile ride. I wish Rick would get rid of that thing. He's even got a clutch to put in it now. But he's been way too lazy to do that. Free donation from a tuber from Windsor. All right, let's see how the big fat tanker fires up on a +2 degrees Celsius winter's day with the 1982 22R Toyota motor. Some pumpage. See if we can get back there. Never drove this sucker in the snow yet, and it's only two-wheel drive, rear wheel. But does have some meaty tires on her. It's a little wet. Well, there's Cialis Chalmers. Hasn't been started for 2 years, since January 2 years ago. That's up soon. Trailer park boys hang out. Carland Wonderland. Oh, what a lovely view.
So from whence we came, bloke's trailer, Rick's deck and nothing else, Graham's trailer, and a whole lot of future fun. Damn it, except the police are here already. Nothing new. Bus was working great, I just never started it this year for a cold start, but every time we used it, she worked good. Now I'll walk around and take some pictures, and I'll post the pictures on YouTube along with last year's pictures at the same day last year, and you can see the difference between 1 year. It'll be interesting. Snow, I mean. Well, since it's plus 2 Celsius out and not much snow, I'm sure you guys are up to waiting till we get some really cold weather and lots of snow like those pictures you just seen. So be patient. It's a pretty boring winter this year.